Hello everybody and welcome back to the channel. Today's watch features a lovely design watch called the Paragon by the company Fraser & Co Watches. My massive thanks to Fraser & Co Watches for kindly loaning me this incredible timepiece for the purposes of review. Honest, unbiased review is normal. I won't be able to keep this watch. This one's going to be sent on to someone else. I'm a bit disappointed that this one won't be staying in my collection, and I'll tell you why very, very shortly. Also, my thanks goes to Steve at the Watch Corner for putting me in contact with Fraser & Co Watches, so thank you very much. You notice I'm wearing gloves today for this one. The reason being, as I say, this one has got to be sent on to someone else. So I've cleaned it off already. I've been wearing it quite a lot. So I've cleaned it up so there's no little grubby fingerprints left on it from me. And I don't want to mark it up any more than is absolutely necessary. Beautiful packaging you get. First thing you're greeted with is the Book of Words, Fraser & Co. Owner's Manual, which has got all the different instructions and so on in there. I've not looked at that. Being a bloke, we don't bother with things like that, do we? Now comes the main event. Move that out of the way. Look at that for packaging. Superb, isn't it? Absolutely superb. We'll undo this little box. And this box is full. I mean, full of goodies. First of all, look, you get greeted with the watch. We'll go talk about that in a minute. You get a commemorative coin, which has actually got the dial of the watch all on there as well. Very, very nice touch. You get a gold tone, warranty, which I've not undone, so there's no fingerprints on that at all. Moving on to the top of the box, you get this lovely little display case feature you can put it on. It's not a case, it's like a little bit of like leathery sort of thing you can put your watch on, display it, purpose driven. Then you get a strap removal tool for doing the pins. You get a little leatherette case so you can put your watch in all your tools, which I've not undone. You can see that's all still sealed. You, of course, get your cleaning cloth, which is there, and you get a spare strap with the Fraser logo on it. Now, I've not changed the strap on it. I've kept it on the supply strap. Reason being, no matter how careful you are, the more careful you try, the more chance you stand of scratching the case of the watch doing a strap removal. This isn't mine, so I wanted to, like, you know, take even more care than I normally do with a watch. A lot of you that know me know that I am a very, very fussy when it comes to my timepieces. I like to keep them looking as new or as new as new as I possibly can. So we'll just put this in here a moment. I know you're looking forward to seeing the actual watch that you get with this. But that's a lovely little selection of goodies you get before you even get into the watch. Here we go. Take this one out nice and carefully. Nice little pillow there. Right, we can move this out of the way. But I think you'll agree, packaging, absolute 10 out of 10. Before you even start, you've got a 10 out of 10 on the packaging. Superb. Very, very, very nice indeed. Right. Now then, here's the watch. First of all, I'll take that sticker off first. Yeah, I put the sticker back on it as well. First of all, you've got that beautiful, beautiful dial on it. Really, really nice indeed. They've done a superb job on it. They really have. You've got your date complication there. You've got the day of the week there, and you've got your 24-hour time there. Very, very, very beautifully done dial. It's, of course, sapphire crystal. You've got the coin edge, non-rotatable bezel. Why would you have a rotating bezel on this? So it's just a coin edge that looks really nice. Beautiful rose gold case on it, which, as you can see, is all nicely cleaned up again. Nice little attention to detail I like on it personally. Correct me if I'm wrong, Fraser Watches, but to me, that looks like a ball bearing that's actually been reset into the crown of the watch to give it more depth. Now, I do like that. That's a design feature that I've personally not seen before, and I absolutely adore that. That's lovely. You've got lovely coin edge effect on your crown as well. Of course, it's not a screw down crown. It's not a diving watch. It's a dress posh watch. That's what I would class this under. You've got your applied indices, which are, of course, in Roman numerals. The lume on it is very much acceptable. Absolutely very, very much acceptable. It really is. For a dress watch, it's one of the best ones I've seen for a dress watch. You're not going to get the same lume as you do on divers because, to be honest, you don't really need it, do you? A diver's watch is a different bracket completely. But this one here is perfectly acceptable on the lume. It really is. But that dial is the star of the show. I mean, that really does pop. You've got like a triangular fluting that's done all through it. And they've done such a superb job on the dial. You've also got a bit of texture here as well, with different levels of applied indices on there, which is very, very nice. And you've got the raised ring around the date and the 24-hour feature. And of course, on the day as well, the half moon there. A very, very, very pretty watch. It really is a very pretty watch. We'll go over to some specs in a moment with it. But, I mean, look at the case. It is absolutely so well executed. It really is. I've left the sticker on the back of this one, as I say, because I'm not keeping this one. This one's going to be sent on to another reviewer. Beautiful butterfly clasp on it, which is done very, very nicely as well. You've got the logo on the back. Hopefully they'll pick it up. My apologies for leaving the sticker on, but I'd like to make sure that the next person has a kind of unboxing experience as well with it. As you can see, it's really, really beautiful. You've got your Fraser & Co. embossed on the strap, which is another nice touch as well. It's just little details that I appreciate as a watch lover. And you've got the same there, the Paragon, the actual name of the watch. Very, very, very lovely looking timepiece. I've really enjoyed my time with this one. I really have. It's been it's very, very comfortable to wear. The only downside I have to say, whoa, he says, dropping the camera. The only downside that I have to say is the strap on it. Now, I've got a 6-inch wrist and I could actually do with another hole in the strap. That's what I would personally like to see, is another hole in the strap. If I was keeping this one, I would probably put another hole in the strap. But of course, I'm not going to because it's not mine. Right, we'll go over some specs in a moment for you. It is I'm very much impressed with it. I really am very much impressed with it. For a company that I didn't really hear of, really, until I come across them on Instagram, and then Steve from the Watch Corner put me onto them. They've done a fantastic job. They really have. Well, Paragon, actually, it comes from the Greek words, and it means quality and excellence, which they've nailed that. They certainly have. It's made of 316 stainless steel, sapphire crystal, top grain leather premium strap, and a quality quartz movement. We'll talk about the movement in a moment. I've gone through what's in the box. Here we go. The movement is a Miyota JR20, Juliet Romeo 20. It's of course quartz. And it's water resistant to 100 meters, which, again, is very, very impressive for basically a dress type watch. Very, very impressive, I think. The size of it is a 12 and a half. The height is 4.18 millimeters. The accuracy is plus to minus 20 seconds per month. The battery life on it, they reckon, is 3 years. You know, I think that's very, very good. Now, I've got to say a negative with this one. It doesn't bother me, but I know it will bother some of you out there. I'll go over the price on this in a moment. The current price of this one is $289.99. So it's around about 250-ish British pounds. Now, I've got to go over one little negative. This might just be on my model that I've got here, but it's worth mentioning. As I say, it doesn't bother me in the slightest. It really doesn't. But the second hand doesn't hit the indices. It doesn't hit the chapter ring ones. It's always before or after, and then every so often it will surprise you and it'll hit one. Now, that doesn't bother me, not in the slightest bit. And I can't say if they're all like this, because I've only got the one to show you. But if that's going to be an issue for you, what thing is only right that I should mention, as you can see there, look. Just a small little niggle, doesn't bother me in the slightest, you know, but if you're a bit OCD, I think that would annoy you. And just bear in mind, I can't speak for every one of the range, just this one I've got here in front of me right now. Right, well, thanks very much for watching. I do appreciate it. And I'll give you a wrist shot now, just to see what you can, so you can see what it looks like on wrist. As I say, I could do with an extra hole. There, and that's it on my 6-inch wrist. It really does look nice. It's a very, very pretty watch. And that dial, I'll stick my neck on the line and say that dial is an award-winning dial. It's so nice. It really is. Right, thank you again to Fraser and Co. Watches for kindly loaning this one to the channel. Thanks also again to Steve from the Watch Corner. Very much appreciated. And don't forget, I'm doing a giveaway of a £299 Swiss watch when I reach 2,000 subscribers. The quicker I get there, the quicker that draw happens. So like, comment, subscribe, share, all the good stuff. Thanks very much for watching. See you later. Bye.